two quarterbacks that really sparked their two teams, Clint Chelf and Case McCaw. First quarter, Chelf, a guy that wasn't necessarily known for the legs, but we saw him have success on the ground, especially in a win against Texas Tech. And on this first touchdown drive for the Pokes, it's primarily Chelf on the ground.
One of the things, one of the ways to stop a quarterback run is the game plan for it. And I don't think Texas expected him to run the ball the way he did today.
Did you expect him to? I mean, honestly,
I didn't, not at all. No. What do you think, Amon?
Well, I think you got to try it. You know, Texas has not had great success at stopping quarterbacks rushing the football, and he's athletic enough. You heard DG talk about his athleticism with his feet, and so if you're me, yeah, you want to try to stop this dominant running game, but he was athletic enough to make them pay.
Here's your spark, though, Joe Bergeron, after it's 14-3. He really starts getting something going here. He has the first 36 yards on this touchdown drive.
Well, they had a great running game really all game long. The problem was they got behind and they had to, you know, depend on the air, but I really thought Malcolm Brown ran it well and Joe as well.
Well, there's your guy, Malcolm Brown, working in the red zone, 2nd and 9. Nice cutback, vision.
I really think they should have ran the ball more in the red zone. I thought they got a little pass happy at times. Give it to the big fella.
Yeah, this was a nice series of runs by Malcolm. At this point in the game, I really thought Texas was going to take over the game with the running game and take the lead.
There's our friends in Afghanistan cheering on their Texas Longhorns. But the final 3 minutes, 39 seconds of the half could have changed the course of the season. That's on a 3rd and 10. Chelf to Juwan Seals. Two plays later, it's this close.
That's unfortunate, guys.
It's that close. That was almost the second interception in the end zone for Texas because Mikel had one earlier in the game.
It's great concentration from Tracy Moore right there. That's a heck of a play.
So now you get the ball back with a minute 15. There's 30 seconds left. This is after a false start penalty, and there goes that momentum. Justin Gilbert the other way, 43-yard touchdown. That is the 6th dot offensive touchdown for Oklahoma State this season, 28-10 at the half.
What I did like about both of those plays, the wheel route for the touchdown and the pick six, is Texas was at least being aggressive. They were a little overly aggressive. I think they were in cover three, and the corner bit underneath and got beat deep. And then, you know, I'd like to see Texas trying to score before the half to really give themselves a shot.
And Ricky, this was a huge drive right here. They had to score a touchdown on this series. And when you kick a field goal, now it's 28-13. You're still down by two big possessions. That was a killer.
And the same thing to open up the game on their first offensive possession. Got close, had to end up kicking a field goal. So Texas defense trying to go back to work, down 28-13. Chelf rolling out, getting the fullback involved. Dalton Santos there, try to bring him down. Chelf again on the run.
I thought Mike Gundy had a great game plan the whole game. I thought they threw the ball well. They didn't run the ball. I didn't see Desmond rolling, I don't think, like, as much as we thought we would. But Chelf played outstanding.
But you're still trading field goals at that point when you're down. This was big because you come back in case picked off by Jacob Levy.
Tony, as a former quarterback, you hate those little crossing routes just 5 yards because he looks wide open. But all he did, he just dropped right back out. How about Levy? 4 interceptions as a middle linebacker. Ooh, that's impressive.
Now, Dalton Santos almost had one big time right when Oklahoma State was backed up near their end zone in the first half. 45 seconds left. Case McCoy trying to stretch the field. That one picked off again. 9 interceptions for Case over the past 5 games. The big difference, though, and we talked about this in the pregame show, more offensive firepower for Oklahoma State, the ability to turn those turnovers into points. Texas came into this game over the past 3, outscoring opponents 40-0 off of turnovers. 14-0 edge in this game for Oklahoma State. They won 38-13.